Welcome back. This is a series of lectures on short lectures on mechanical thrombectomy and topics of interest in stroke. So continuing from where we left yesterday, today we'll discuss a little bit about guiding catheters. So in the first part I showed you how femoral puncture is done and the catheter is taken to the carotid artery. The path from the femoral artery to the carotid is not very straight. If you want to take very supple catheters from the groin, from the thigh all the way into the brain, you have to have a highway sort of thing, a very straight road through which the small catheters can be very easily taken into the brain. So for that we use what is called a guiding catheter. Guiding catheter is essentially a stiff catheter which is extending all the way from the groin, from the thigh, from the femoral artery into the carotid artery. So it's a stiff catheter, something like a scaffolding, very stiff catheter through which the small catheters and stented tubers can easily be. So this is till where from the inner carotid artery you have the guiding catheter through which the other catheters can be taken distally. So different catheters, small catheters, distal access catheter, many catheters can be taken through this stiff catheter. Now this is one of an example of a guiding catheter, Neuron Max. This is one of the commonly used catheter. It comes in different, it's a 6 French catheter. It comes in different lengths, 80 centimeter, 90 centimeter. It has got a distal part, you know, which is very, very supple. So this is one guiding catheter which is used. But for mechanical thrombectomy, one of the preferred catheter is what is called a BGC. Many a times, you know, interventionists use the term BGC. So neurologists should know about this term, what is called a balloon guide catheter. So this is nothing but a guiding catheter which has got a balloon at its tip. So you have a balloon at its tip. So to understand more about balloon catheter, a little bit of physics is, you know, you should know a little bit about the pressures acting on the clot. So this is the internal carotid artery, this is the anterior A1 segment of the anterior cerebral artery. You have the clot at the M1 extending into the bifurcation. This is the superior division, this is the inferior division. And you have a clot at M1 which is extending partially into both the branches of middle cerebral artery. Now what happens is there is the systemic pressure which is acting, which is normal systemic pressure acting through the internal carotid artery, pushing the clot away. And when this is there might be a reversal of flow and the pressure through the anterior cerebral artery also is pressing the clot away. And if there are good collaterals, distal to the clot there is the pressure of the collateral circulation which is pushing the clot against. So normally the pressure on the clot is P systemic plus P through the anterior cerebral minus. These two forces are pushing the clot away and the pressure in the collaterals which is pushing the clot towards. So when you are using a balloon guide catheter like this, you are actually cutting off the systemic pressure. So the pressure acting on the clot becomes less, pushing the clot away, and the pressure, collateral pressure which is pushing the clot against the distally is this. So this is another animation which shows. This is a traditional mechanical thrombectomy where if you are not using a balloon guide catheter, because of the systemic pressure, the clot can fragment and can go distally. But when you are using a balloon guide catheter, you inflate the balloon and arrest the forward flow of blood in the carotid artery. There is stagnation of blood here when you are aspirating. So when you are pulling out the clot using a stent retriever, the chance of the blood clot coming out completely without fragmentation is much higher. Higher first pass efficacy, lower number of passes required. That means, you know, even with the first pass, single pass or two passes, the clot comes out. The time taken for recanalization is much less, and thickey 3 recanalization. That means the complete vasculature is recanalized completely without any embolism. The new territory is also much higher. So this is a little bit about the guiding catheters. So summarizing, guiding catheter is a stiff catheter extending from the femoral artery all the way to carotid, and in mechanical thrombectomy balloon guide catheter is preferred, but we will discuss the options in the next lecture. Thank you for your patient listening. This is a short lecture. If you have any doubts, I would request you to WhatsApp me personally so that I can try to communicate with you directly. Thank you for your patient listening. Please do let us know your comments, criticisms and suggestions, and also subscribe to this channel, the Stroke Academy. Thank you.